Hello there. Thank you very much for watching this video. My name is Wollelaw Agmas. I'm an infectious disease doctor and currently a preventive medicine fellow here at Maine Medical Center. Today, I am here to talk about COVID-19 vaccine, which is very exciting news. You know, this virus has affected our lives in one way or another. Most of us are working from home, and at the same time, we're supposed to deal with our kids because schools have been closed. And even worse, some people have lost their loved ones. And we have been hearing such kind of unfortunate stories for the last almost 1 year now. Today, I'm not here to talk about the stories. I'm here to talk about COVID vaccine. But before that, I'll give you just a brief update. So let's get started. What's COVID-19? The word COVID represents coronavirus disease that was first noted in 2019. The World Health Organization came up with that name. So it's a disease caused by a type of coronavirus called SARS-CoV-2, which is also an acronym that represents severe acute respiratory syndrome due to coronavirus type 2. And also the name corona came from its crown-like structure that's found on the surface of the virus, as I have circled in the picture. And that's called the spike protein. This spike protein is very important for the virus because it uses it to infect human cells. To give you an update about the number of infections and deaths, as of December 2020, more than 80 million infections and 1.7 million deaths have been reported. When you look at the situation in the United States, more than 20 million infections and 320,000 deaths have been reported. In Maine, we have around 20,000 infections and 300 deaths thus far. The graph shown here represents the number of infections in the state of Maine between March and December of 2020, as reported by the Maine CDC. The red portion represents cases related to outbreaks, while the blue portion represents all of the other cases. Look at the graph in November and December, how the cases are increasing. What is at stake here is that this virus is not going anywhere. It's not getting better. It's rather getting worse. What are the symptoms of COVID-19? I'm sure you are very familiar with the symptoms because all of them are listed in MaineHealth's daily questionnaire. So the common symptoms are fever, headache, and respiratory symptoms such as runny nose, cough, shortness of breath, or nasal congestion. Uncommon but possible symptoms include vomiting, diarrhea, and some weird symptoms, such as loss of sense of smell and taste. Now let's talk about the vaccine. So there are several types of COVID-19 vaccines in development. As of December 2020, messenger RNA vaccines are the first authorized for use in the United States. So how does that messenger RNA vaccine work? It works by giving an instruction to our cells to make a harmless spike protein. So what does that mean? When we get the mRNA vaccine, it gives instruction to make that harmless spike protein. And at that time, our body thinks that we are getting a coronavirus infection, and the immune system produces an antibody. By doing so, the vaccine helps our body to learn how to protect coronavirus in the future. And then the cell breaks down and gets rid of that mRNA. This technology of messenger RNA vaccine has been studied for more than 30 years to make vaccines for other viral infections. So it is not a brand new technology. MaineHealth has started giving vaccinations as of December 15th. The picture shown here is one of our physicians, Dr. Christina DiMaggio, giving the first COVID vaccine to one of our ICU nurses. As I mentioned earlier, two mRNA vaccines by Pfizer and Moderna are currently available for use. Both these vaccines require special storage and transportation. And that is because both of these vaccines need to be kept at extremely cold temperature. For instance, the Pfizer vaccine needs to be stored at around minus 70 degrees Celsius. That is pretty much means it needs to be stored in dry ice. Similarly, the Moderna vaccine needs to be stored at around minus 20 degrees Celsius. So both vaccines are given two times through shots intramuscularly, 21 days apart for the Pfizer vaccine, and 28 days apart for the Moderna vaccine. I want to highlight here that it is very important to take the second shot for the vaccine to be fully protected. So are these vaccines effective? So let's see the vaccines we are familiar with to understand how effective the new vaccines are. The flu vaccine that we are taking every year is about 50% effective. And the pneumonia vaccine is also around 60 to 70% effective. But interestingly, the new COVID vaccine studies reported high efficacy. For instance, the Pfizer vaccine study reported 95% efficacy beginning 28 days from the second shot. A similar report by the Moderna vaccine study reporting an efficacy of 94%, 14 days from the second shot. This is huge. This is very impressive. So why should we take this vaccine? We should take this vaccine because COVID-19 is a deadly and very contagious infection. As we have seen in the previous slides, those data, all the indicators are showing it's getting worse. The number of infection, number of deaths, number of hospitalizations are getting worse every time. And people who work in the healthcare setting, like you and me, are at especially high risk for obvious reasons. And no other effective prevention tools thus far. We know that using masks, hygiene, such as using alcohol swab and social distancing can help to prevent the spread of infection. But unfortunately, people are not following guidelines. So they're not working. Then that's why the infection is getting worse. And another reason is that both vaccine studies enrolled a huge number of participants and showed efficacy. So putting all these things together, the overall benefits are significantly outweigh the potential side effects that we get from the vaccine. So is it safe? That's also another valid question. So neither the Pfizer nor the Moderna studies reported a serious side effects from the vaccines. Some people reported symptoms following the vaccines. Those symptoms are listed here. Most people complained of having pain, swelling, and redness at the injection site. And other people also reported having fatigue, fever, chills, headache, and allergic reactions. Note that these symptoms reported following the COVID vaccine are also very common symptoms reported following other vaccines too. So just to understand better, regarding the symptoms reported following the vaccine, I have put a comparison here, another vaccine that is given for shingles. So the symptoms listed on the left side were reported by people who have received either of this vaccine, the shingles vaccine and the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine. So overall, 38% of individuals who have received shingles vaccine reported any of the symptoms listed in here, such as pain, redness, swelling, muscle pain, feeling tired, headache, chills, fever, all this, either any of these. And a similar report by the Pfizer vaccine, but at a lower rate, at about 26% of those individuals who received the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine reported any of the symptoms listed on the left side. So what I'm saying is that these symptoms reported following the COVID vaccines are not unique for the Pfizer vaccine. What about long-term effects? In general, most vaccine side effects happen within 6 to 8 weeks. And the Pfizer study has followed those individuals who received the vaccine for an average of 8 weeks. And there were no safety concerns reported within that duration. And of course, these individuals are still being closely followed for any potential new symptoms. If you would like to dig more to understand who participated in those vaccine studies, the Pfizer study enrolled more than 43,000 individuals. All of them were 16 years or older, and they were from 6 different countries in 39 US states. And they also did a good job to include people from different race and ethnicity. If you look at the individuals from US, 6% were Asian, 10% were Black, 13% were Hispanic, and 45% of those individuals were aged 56 or older. A similar composition was reported in the Moderna study. They enrolled around 30% of participants, and all of them were 18 years or older. 7,000 were 65 years or older. And also, 1/3 of those 30,000 individuals were from community of color. That is a big number. They also included 5,000 participants who had medical conditions. I want to also mention that the Pfizer study also included people with medical conditions such as cancer, diabetes, heart conditions, liver conditions, HIV, hepatitis B, C infection, different medical conditions. Those individuals were also included in the Pfizer study as well. So who was not included in the vaccine study? Pregnant women, nursing mothers, children, and people who had COVID infection were not included in the study. So what does that mean? It means we do not have information about the safety of this vaccine in this segment of the population. So for now, no vaccine is suggested in persons who had history of COVID infection within the last 90 days. And of course, obviously for those individuals who have COVID symptoms. And who gets the vaccine first? So the CDC came up with a guidance to give the vaccine in 4 phases. In phase 1 included are people working in the healthcare setting and people who live and work at a long-term care facility, and individuals with medical condition and elderly people are going to get the vaccine in the first phase. In the second phase included are critical workers, such as people who work in the industry, groceries, teachers, homeless individuals, and prisoners will get the vaccine in the second phase. The rest of the population will get in phase 3 and phase 4. What else should we know? So we know that there are misinformations out there in social media. So here are the facts that you need to know. COVID-19 vaccine will never give you a COVID-19 infection because there is no live virus in that vaccine. COVID-19 vaccine will not alter your DNA composition because the RNA that's given as a vaccine will never come in contact with the DNA. It doesn't go into the nucleus. That's where the DNA is kept. COVID-19 vaccine does not contain any tracking material or GPS. For now, it is given for free to everyone, at least at the beginning phase. And it is not mandated, which means no one will force you to take the vaccine. So if you need more information, we have a COVID line, the number is here, or on MaineHealth homepage, there's a COVID-19 tab. When you click that, it will take you to this screen, and there are more resources in here. The employee health and vaccine frequently asked questions are answered there. Still, if you need more information, you can visit the CDC website here. They update it every day, and they're good resource. And again, thank you so much for watching this video.